tight, cause I'm low on the phone, you see. So I talk till I drop, you see. How could I have a heart made of stone? Why you... Oh, and we synchronize. It's exactly what I thought when I fantasized. Playing games with my mind, making us collide. And we know how it goes when we're out at night. And I don't know how we make it out when we make out on the low. Even if it rains, you'd rather make it snow. Both you and me know we gotta let it go. Laying on the ground, wondering why it's so cold. How we make it out when we make out on the low. Even if it rains, you'd rather make it snow. Both you and me know we gotta let it go. Laying on the ground, wondering why. When you patronize, you're so satisfied. When I dig in the dirt, you're in paradise. And I know that you know I can sleep at night. Oh, and you're by my side. And it's smooth how you move, cause I'm petrified. Setting traps in my head, messing with my mind. When you talk, can you talk, but I know you're lying. And I don't know. If I was to call your phone, I know you'd click. Baby, you can have the throne, I call it quits. You can even have my car, I don't need it. I've been inside my room since you left it. Thinking about the place where we first kissed. Oh, and I don't know how we make it out.
When you're coming off the court, you only have a couple of minutes with the players. How do you prepare for those interviews, and how do you get such great answers on the fly with the little time that you do have?
Well, something I was taught from the very beginning was, you know, it's not about you, it's about the person you're interviewing. That's why people are watching. So how can you get your point across in the most concise manner that also allows them to be in the best position to give you an intelligent or meaningful or emotional response?
We're the land of the free and the home of the brave.
It's always fun to look around and see fans singing our Star Spangled Banner. Getting in the spirit. Should be a good one tonight. Don't go away. Welcome, everyone. Let's get ready for some NBA basketball on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. And giving us the rundown from the sideline, David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Hey, Kevin. Well, another Kevin, Kevin Durant, is just as dedicated to his craft as you are at yours. But it's off the court where he says he's been on a search. Pushing my limits, the flow of life, the people I meet, the environment I want to live in. All that stuff fulfills me more than anything. Kevin, the game of basketball opens so many doors for him to search.
It does indeed. Thanks, David. Now that we have a second, let's take a quick peek at the rebounding numbers for the last handful of seasons. For DeAndre Jordan,
It's a concerning trend for him. Whether he's lost some strength or just isn't putting in as much effort on the glass as he used to, he's not rebounding nearly as effectively anymore. And that's something that needs to change.
Now let's check out our starters for the Los Angeles Lakers. They've got Morris. Dennis Schroeder is out there with Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Then there's Andre Drummond. And it's Kuzma in at the small forward. And for the Nets, Brown out there with Irving. And it's Durant. Then there's Harris. And it's Aldridge in at the five. Roman the paint. Not many teams have the personnel, Greg, to work the ball through the post, but that's what we're going to see plenty of tonight. These two teams can do it.
No doubt, Kevin. It can really add a dimension to your offense, and it creates different rotations defensively, especially when you've got someone down low that's going to demand a double team. And so I'm interested to see, in essence, some old school basketball in terms of how teams rotate out of that post.
I am too.
Thrown down with force. Drummond with great feel around the rim. Now, usually he's one of the leading dunkers in the NBA because he doesn't waste any time or motion in there.
And here's Schroeder following the three-pointer by Kyrie Irving. Schroeder passes to Kuzma. It's rebounded by Durant. Brooklyn's gone 2 of 2 from three-point range here in the first quarter. From the arc, Morris with the rebound. And it's Schroeder with the ball. He brings it up for the Lakers. Four-point game. And Caldwell-Pope gets the basket.
Very effective at spacing the floor. Kentavious Caldwell-Pope has gone from an average outside shooter to a dangerous one.
Got that bucket in no time at all. Irving's got 6 points.
The real. Come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
A little back and forth from long range. I love it. That's a terrific answer there.
Nobody near Schroeder. Out to Kuzma. And it's out of bounds, and they say it was last touched by Durant. So first quarter, just over a minute and a half in. And it's Schroeder in the corner. No good from outside. For Brooklyn, they've gone 3 of 4 from the field to start out the game. And the Nets, another three.
Great three-point shooting here out of the gate. That makes 4 makes already from long distance.
Bring music scorching those Nets. How long can they keep this up, though?
Kuzma can't get it to go.
Hey, you know, I like the competitive spirit, but when you look at it, I think he rushed that three a little bit because he was trying to get back at his opponent.
And creating a little separation here, gaining some confidence.
Yeah, you get the sense that they're going to start stretching this lead out a little bit.
And Kevin Durant, one of the greatest scorers to ever play. I mean, not the most prolific scorer, but perhaps the most talented. He's dangerous from any part of the floor.
Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Bounce pass, Schroeder. Drummond passes to Morris. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist.
Man, what a pass that was there. He really, really relishes making the game easier for his teammates.
Greg, as scores go, Kevin Durant's as efficient as any.
I mean, Durant has an insane field goal percentage for the shots that he takes. I mean, when you factor in how many threes he puts up, it gets even more impressive. Durant takes so many shots where he's covered and is still efficient. It's just mind-blowing. Well, they'll be happy with that look, even though it didn't fall.
You know what? That's a confidence shaker for him, though. I mean, that's a shot he expects to make every time.
And no doubt, they'd love to see him get a lot more of those opportunities.
And that deficit will go away quickly if he does, Greg.
Well, I like the way he capped off that drive. The one-hand hole punch.
Defensively, giving up far too many open rhythm looks.
And to battle back, they've got to shore up the defense. I mean, there's no other way to come back from a deficit unless you play good defense.
Here's Here's Schroeder. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game.
Boy, you can see the connection these guys have. They ran the play well. The defense had no idea how to deal with it.
Got that one up quick.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
And, you know, it's an all-out effort they've come in with. Very aggressive offense so far.
And the Lakers decide to take their first timeout here. Now let's take a look at the number of second chance points these teams have had over the last month. These guys never give up on a possession. In third, the Nets.
They have gone all out to win the rebounding battle every night, and it's been paying off. I mean, the second chance points thus far have been really impressive.
Kuzma against Harris. Kuzma inside and a missed layup.
It's almost as if there's a lid on the hoop for him right now. He still hasn't gotten one to fall in the court.
Took him no time at all on that one. Durant's got 7 points in the game.
Excellent all-around performance so far, hence the big lead.
Yeah, you know, they've had the advantage at both ends. They've got all the momentum early on.
Now, here's Kuzma. He's still scoreless so far in this one.
Oh, what a finish!
My goodness!
And look at Drummond, capable of rising up and dropping an absolute hammer.
And it's going to be out of bounds. The Nets will retain possession. Here's KD, and then Durant with the jam.
You know, with Harris, if you're open, he's going to make sure he finds you.
So it's the Lakers now, down by 12. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of Miami.
You got to give them an A for effort. Just fell a little bit short in that one.
Yeah, they were really close right there. Just couldn't string together a few key plays to help get them over the top for the win.
Here's Irving. Another one falls for Brooklyn.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
You're exactly right. I mean, everything seems to be dropping. Impressive scoring here.
Now, here's Caldwell Pope. He's coming off a 28-point game against the Heat in Miami. Count that one. Schroeder's got his second basket of the night.
And really, it's been a major aspect of their offense in the early stages here. Their success working the ball inside and getting points from close range.
Well, he's just zoned in. I mean, in most cases, taking quality shots very much within the flow of the offense.
Caldwell Pope outside. Knocked away. And here comes Brown, leading the fast break. Here's Harris, and slam dunk by Harris.
How about that? The flush from Harris. People forget this guy is 6'6", and he's got a little burst and bounce, too.
Here's Schroeder, and he drops in the layup off the glass. Schroeder's got 6 points.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 coming from inside the paint.
Irving for three. Gets it to go for bucket number 8. He's taken just 10 shots.
Yeah, they built up this lead 3 points at a time.
And I like the strategy. It's a great strategy. Bury those threes early, and it'll open up the inside for him later on.
Oh, what a pass. And then he lays it in with the circus move.
So smooth.
He could have messed that up trying for a big slam. Nice work going to the layup. Boy, he's got to be disappointed in the result there. I mean, the defender really didn't make any impact at all.
Caldwell Pope kicks to Kuzma. Here's Drummond, and it's Drummond with the jam.
And way to finish and cut into that lead a little bit.
Yeah, but look at the basket guy still shaking.
Well, I tell you what, he loaded up as much power as he could behind that two-hander.
And the defense is in disbelief here, triple after triple.
When that happens, you simply just hope they start cooling off.
And the Lakers call time here. Well, Greg, with your son getting drafted, you joined the ranks of some historic NBA father-son duo.
You know, I got the opportunity to play with Arvydas Sabonis in Portland, and remember, DeMontis as a little kid.
No kidding.
He's an all-star last year. You know, I think you're going to have an influx of that in the coming years. Dwayne Wade's son is a terrific player. We know about LeBron's son's ability. He's possibly heading to the league one day. You just never know. I'm as a dad, it's going to get the opportunity to watch his son play, excited. But I think you're going to see more of this in the future.
Cole and Greg Anthony, I like the way that sounds. DeAndre Jordan's checked in for the Nets. Green comes in for Joe Harris.
Well, a lot of tough teams in this league. Here's where Brooklyn sits right now.
And you go back to their offense, the most explosive in the league. I mean, everyone talks about the great offense beating great defenses. And I tell you what, they make it difficult to hang with.
Outside Jordan. Up again. Controls the rebound and puts it back up and in. And the Nets lead by 17. And a look at how the hustle game has been going for the Nets.
And it's been about their defense. They're playing with a frenetic pace, putting a lot of pressure on the ball handlers and forcing turnovers.
They've gotten their fair share of points off turnovers so far tonight, too.
And he's not going to miss that sort of an opportunity from deep.
Here's Irving, fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points. So one free throw coming up.
Monster quarter for him. He's put the team on his back, trying to carry them to the W.
Well, you can be the judge of if it's fair or not, but Kyrie Irving has earned himself the reputation of being moody, to say the least.
Yeah, and you know, sometimes that sword cuts both ways. Sometimes it's the player, sometimes it's the media, and the media's perception. It's a combination of the two. Clearly, Kyrie can sometimes go off on tangents and come from left field in interviews. I mean, he's not the only player, present or past, that's been guilty of that. One thing you can't deny, though, is this guy loves the game. And it's a matter of continuing to mature and grow as a leader. So I say give him more time, and he'll refine himself in that area.
Here's Horton Tucker. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. And Irving gets it to go on the assist by Green. Irving's got 29.
Well, you got to be in awe of what he's doing this quarter, actually destroying the opponent.
Here's Caruso. A three-pointer, no good. Nets leading by 19. Brown finds Jordan. Outside, KD. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a three-point play chance here for him.
No easy way to hold KD down. He's slick, he's slippery, he's smooth with the ball. That's why he draws fouls.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
And with his percentage at 87, he's done just about everything they could have asked when it comes to free throw shooting.
You know, one thing about getting going at the free throw line like he has this season, it can continue to carry over.
And Caruso's got the ball here for the Lakers. Passes it to Harrell. To halt the run. And Marc Gasol, good for three.
Man, you've really got to appreciate the versatility of Gasol. I mean, he's a big man with range. I love seeing him square up from deep.
Bucket is good. Irving's got 31.
And he has just been in a flow offensively. Terrific game. He has been the X factor.
Outside Matthews. Pass to Harrell. Here's Horton Tucker. Pass to Harrell. It's stolen by Green. And Irving with a clear path to the hoop. Finished off the break. Irving's got 33. Well, they're really making a point of keeping the ball moving around.
That's the key. The D can't focus on one player. And no matter what anybody tells you, that ball will always move quicker than the defender.
Durant with the steal. And again, Kyrie Irving. He has 35.
You know, guys are a little shaky when they're around Durant because defensively he's got long arms, he's active with his hands, and that's why he comes up with those steals.
Here's Matthews, and it's Matthews with the jam.
Outstanding execution. Good job working the ball inside.
Brown outside. It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
Yeah, they got that one, but early on, it's really been a struggle for them to secure that defensive backboard.
And because it's still early, I wouldn't read too much into it. There's still a lot of game left.
And improving as a shot maker every year, Harrell has to be accounted for defensively.
And the first timeout called of the game for Brooklyn. Well, it is a long season, we know that, and the All-Star break provides Greg some respite, but how do you keep your body fresh as we're heading down the stretch here?
Kevin, you got to listen to the training staff. I mean, first and foremost, teams are getting more advanced, measuring when players are wearing down and trying to protect them. All the tools are there, but you've got to take advantage. And the other thing is mentally, you've got to be fresh. It's not just about your body being fresh. So sometimes you need to be able to shut the brain down in terms of the game and get your focus elsewhere.
And Brooklyn making a change here. Claxton's checked in. Now that we have a moment, let's take a peek at the teams that are leading the league in blocks. Fourth spot held by the Lakers.
I mean, terrific rim protection. I mean, they rotate and help on the inside as well as anybody. And, of course, you want to keep offenses on the outside shooting jump shots, and that continues to be the goal.
Kept alive.
You know, at the end of the day, size does matter, especially on the glass.
And the pass to Caruso. And Brown over to help. Here's Horton Tucker. It's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession. And now another look at that mobile one block defensive performance.
And that'll give them a jolt. Nothing like a rejection to light a fire under you.
.127 left in the first quarter. And there's the call on Durant. That's his first foul. Brooklyn on defense. Here's Horton Tucker. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him.
And they've done a nice job controlling the defensive backboard to start this game.
Not one second chance bucket allowed. That is finishing off good defense.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels.
Here's Harrell. After the basket by Brooklyn, Matthews, no one around him, at three off the mark. And here's the fast break. Durant leading the way. Yes, and it's Irving picking up the assist. Durant's got 14 points for the game.
Yeah, they are really starting to push it now.
There's 31 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Here's Gasol. His shot is good, making him a perfect 2-for-2 from the floor.
Boy, the confidence of Gasol on the block is really impressive to see. I mean, once he gets good positioning, he goes right to work.
Here's Claxton. Bangs home the trifecta.
And off to an incredible start here early from long range.
Lighting it up from outside. Hard to keep up with this.
Caruso looking for an opening. Pass to Harrell. Oh, that's blocked. Here's Durant, and finished off by KD.
Durant's a pleasure to watch moving in transition. So fluid and always under control.
What a performance for Kyrie Irving. He has been the story for Brooklyn. They kept going to him again and again, and he delivered with a monster quarter. We'll return shortly. Well, Greg, we know he's already a solid scorer, but Kyle Kuzma spoke to us before the game about evolving his game.
Biggest area of growth would definitely be on the defensive end and my playmaking ability. This year, I'm just trying to be a consistent defender, find my teammates, because I have so much attention offensively. So, I think those are two areas.
Now, having played with superstars, Kuzma is learning what it takes to win.
He's getting only so many shots per game, so I applaud him for finding other ways to contribute to his team with an eye toward the greater goal.
And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And the Nets pretty much in control here, it would seem.
They came in on a mission, razor-sharp offense in that first period.
Yeah, I agree. That was a flawless offensive performance so far. I mean, the shots have been falling. They're making good decisions. That's a nice recipe there.
And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's the second quarter of play. So for the Lakers right now, Marc Gasol is out there with Harrell. Then it's Matthews, and it's Caruso in at the point guard position. It's good from long range.
Well, Irving can shoot it with little warning. I mean, he's just that quick. No time to contest if you're not there before the shot.
And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, guys, we all know that there are some people who dislike James Harden's style of play. They're bored watching him shoot free throws. He said, "I see how teams guard me and find ways to exploit it. I just outthink the game, and I'm faulted for it." Kevin, that may be, but it's hard to argue with the results. Back to you.
You're right. One of the top scorers in league history, David. Thanks for that report. And turnovers have been the issue for him.
You can see the coaches have gotten into him a little bit about this. They've got to do a better job of taking care of the ball.
Now, here's Matthews. Last time out, he had 14 points. The feed to Harrell. Pass to Horton Tucker. Clock at 4. It's good. Horton Tucker's got his first 2 points of the night.
And you can see he just caught a glimpse of the open man on the perimeter and immediately got him the basketball.
And that one's good, Irving.
The defense is far too slow to close out on those three-point attempts.
And those triples, they sure do add up quickly, don't they? I mean, they've got to make some kind of adjustment here.
Well, you know, teams look for plus sixes, players whose wingspans exceed their height by a half foot. Montrezl Harrell is a 6'7 player with a 7'4 wingspan. If you're struggling with the math, ladies and gentlemen, that's a plus 9.
Now, here's Matthews. 5 points in the game. Horton Tucker, that's good.
Moving it around, 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
You know, nothing makes a coach happier than selflessness on the basketball court.
Draws contact on the shot, and now a 3-point play chance as he'll head to the line. And between his length and his athleticism, Montrezl Harrell well-suited for that role of small ball center, Greg, in today's NBA.
Yeah, I mean, he's fearless. Even giving up a few pounds, a few inches, he'll go right at you and making steady improvements as a rebounder year over year.
Here's what Brooklyn's going with right now. LaMarcus Aldridge is checked in for Nicholas Claxton. Harris comes in for Kevin Durant. And it's Luwawu Cabarro in for Brown. That's good from Irving. Greg, in New York, you obviously played in a number of championship-contending teams. What do the Knicks have to do to get back to that feel, that kind of team?
Well, listen, it starts with stability across the board, but mainly that means at the top. And you got to give this new front office, this new regime, an opportunity. I think they got some good young pieces. But title contenders are not in a constant state of flux right now. They've got to take their baby steps here and start moving in the right direction.
Like you say, it does begin in the front office. And here's Kuzma, following the 3 moments ago from LaMarcus Aldridge. Lakers shooting their first free throw of the game right now. On defense, the Nets. And Drummond throws it down.
Yeah, first and foremost, he's a pass-first team player. It's Caldwell Pope. Love seeing that.
The drive by Aldridge. The rebound by the Lakers. And in the second quarter, a little under 3.5 minutes played already. The wide-open look here for Kuzma. Off target from outside.
And the well is running dry for him right now. Nothing falling.
And, you know, you can sense his frustration. This is going to be a test of his resolve here.
Now Caldwell Pope taking a look at the scoring numbers. Right now he averages about 9 points a game. Pass to Drummond. Kuzma with it. They shoot again. And there's the nice layup by Drummond. Drummond's got 4 this quarter.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Yeah, you can't say that with enough emphasis. I mean, the defenders are just not being aggressive enough down low. You got to play with some physicality in the paint.
What a find by Griffin. He's a lot more skilled as a passer than he gets credit for. As far as power forwards go, he has terrific vision.
And they're on the break. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Boy, that's a hard man to slow down once he's on the move. I wouldn't want to be the guy who has to step in front of Aldridge.
Shooting. First trip to the line for him here.
One of the areas where he has excelled all season long. How about 87% from the line?
And, fellas, I think you have to like his improvements over his free throw numbers from a year ago. It's not a significant number or a huge amount, but it's improvement nonetheless.
And the first one drops.
You know, players like Aldridge are a little bit of a diminishing breed in the NBA, a master in the low post with all sorts of ways to score in the paint.
Both free throws good from Aldridge. Schroeder with the ball. He's coming off a 10-point game against the Heat in Miami. Count that bucket. 16 points for Andre Drummond.
Well, he's done his part, no doubt about it. Still yet to miss in the game.
Here's Luwawu. Schroeder, right side. He kicks it to Caldwell Pope. Here's Kuzma. Sinks the three-pointer.
Tell you what, guys, he seems to improve with every game. I mean, Kuzma continues to hone his catch-and-shoot game.
Here's Luwawu. Offensive rebound, Aldridge. And the bucket is good. 3-point play chance here for him.
And the rebound and the follow show you what he is all about. Gritty and determined with a soft touch to match.
Brooklyn shooting the sixth attempt at the free throw line tonight.
And how about as a group, 80% on the season, one of their best attributes.
Really, guys, it's just come together for them at the charity stripe this season. I mean, the confidence is there, and so too are the results.
Tyler Johnson, he's checked in for Brooklyn. And that one falls for LaMarcus Aldridge. Greg, as a point guard, you must have had so much fun being surrounded by so much terrific talent at UNLV.
You know, Larry Johnson, Stacey Augmon, I mean, I could go on and on. And you're right, I was blessed to play alongside these guys. They were incredible talents, finishers. And, you know, you don't always appreciate it going through that moment, but the fact that we're all still close and stay in contact, man, what an awesome experience to be a part of that team.
Chemistry must have been off the charts on that team.
It was, and we had a lot of personalities, man. It was a different era back then. But I tell you, again, I wouldn't trade that experience for anything.
And here's Chioza. He'll bring it up for the Nets. They defeated the Pelicans in their last game.
And that one was all about offensive execution, running your plays, picking your spots.
Yeah, you know, not deviating from the game plan is critical. You got to trust in the system.
Here's Schroeder following the three-pointer by Brooklyn. That one drops for him.
And he's really shot the ball well, but it hasn't been contagious.
The three from Johnson. Good on the three-point shot. Johnson's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball.
Their third three-pointer in a row.
Adjustment time for these guys. The defense has to make some adjustment here.
Here's Kuzma. The shot's good on the assist by Schroeder. Kuzma's got 5 points so far.
Boy, that's exactly the kind of strength Kuzma has to show, guys. I mean, take that contact, expect it, and still be able to convert. You've got to do that at this level.
Just playing with poise and confidence, and they continue to put points on the board.
Boy, I like the way they're playing. A very smart first half, quality shots, not wasting possessions.
And that one's good. Schroeder.
And despite the size disadvantage, attacking the heart of that defense.
You know what, guys, honestly, I didn't think he'd win that battle. I mean, that's a lot of height to give up.
And I like the fact that he really was unfazed by that scoreless first quarter, and now you can see him getting into a rhythm.
It's stolen by Harris. Oh, and here comes Johnson all alone. Whistle blows, basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play.
No misses for him yet in this quarter. Solid as a rock.
The Nets have been excellent at the free throw line here today, a flawless 6-for-6. Jordan, he's checked in for the Nets.
What's up?
Well, in the dunk contest, we saw Michael Jordan take on Dominique Wilkins. These days, not as many star players are participating in these skills competitions, like Greg, the slam dunk.
I think it's a great point you raised, Kevin, and I think in part because back in that era, you know, the reality is guys didn't make the kind of dollars they make today. And there was more risk, I guess, in the mindset of guys today, and they didn't want to take that challenge on. So I wish we would see more of our stars in the slam dunk contest, but
yes.
I don't think that's going to be the case, unfortunately, as much as we'd all like to see it.
Shoots the three. Chioza's shot is good. Chioza's got 6 here in this quarter.
Having a lot of trouble stopping the three-point shot.
And they're not making up for it with their own shots from deep either, so that's a double-edged sword there.
Now, here's Caldwell Pope. Shot clock at 6. And Drummond throws it down.
This is what Drummond is known for, fellas. I mean, assertive, aggressive, relentless, hardworking. He's just a dogged offensive rebounder.
And he's got his first chance at the line here.
not the best statistic for him in terms of his performance at the line. Very low numbers.
You know, his performance at the foul line this season might be the first thing he points to as a priority to improve.
And Brooklyn making a change here. Brown's checked in.
And at last season's trade deadline, Andre Drummond traded away basically for a second-round pick, a shockingly low return for a guy who was once considered a franchise player.
And, you know, we can't measure heart. I mean, he's not as big as the other power forwards, but his jumping ability and mindset is incredible.
Now, here's Caldwell Pope. They get a hand on it. It's stolen by Green. And it's Green with the jam.
And Green getting off the floor there for the dunk. Really like watching him sky up for those.
And Greg, why is it that the Pistons got so little in exchange for Drummond?
Well, I think he was an impending free agent. I think Detroit looking to rebuild. Also, it says something about the center position in today's game.
DeAndre Jordan. That's his first personal foul.
The Lakers have gone 2-for-2 in the game at the line.
And in terms of team numbers, the free throw percentage is right at 74.
And guys, that allows their opponents to play very aggressive defense if they choose to, knowing it's not a bad thing to send them to the foul line.
Free throw, good, Drummond.
Selected ninth overall in the 2012 draft, Drummond's carved out a nice NBA career for himself.
Nicholas Claxton's checked in for Jeff Green. And both free throws good for Drummond.
And didn't have a single free throw in that first quarter, but he started to play with a little bit more of an edge to his game here in the second. And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D out of position, you could see the frustration on his face.
And again, the Lakers, no good. And for Brooklyn, they're shooting an almost unfair 78% from the field. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. It's on Dennis Schroeder. The Nets have gone a perfect 7 of 7 from the line tonight.
Two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good.
Yeah, nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
My kind of hoops. Straight ahead, playing downhill, and physical.
And he makes both free throws. Here's Schroeder, 13 points in the game. Poked away. It's stolen by Johnson. Here's Brown. Nice shot from the wing. Brown's got 6.
And this is why coaches talk about playing with pace. The scoreboard tells it all.
That really has been the difference. I mean, they've been the better team in transition.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
What? You mean the throwdown at the end? I'll tell you what, fellas. I mean, the highlight shows are going to pain them even more.
And it's in there.
Man, it's nice to see Matthews get involved inside, showing a nice touch around the basket.
Shot on the wing, and good. He got the English that time as it falls. He's got 12. And so it's Schroeder with the ball. He'll bring it up for Los Angeles. Following this game, they hit the road. They'll take on the Knicks in New York. And I'm sure they're anxious to get back home, as that will be game 6 of this 7-game road trip.
And working, Kevin, themselves to the line here in the second. A nice way to get your offense going.
And maybe cause some foul trouble along the way as well.
And we know what that can do. It pays off typically in good fashion for you.
Timeout called, the Nets.
The Barclays Center, the welcome to the court. Your Nets dancers.
So for the Nets, KD's checked in for Joe Harris, and Kyrie Irving subbed in for Tyler Johnson. And the Lakers also making a switch. Marcus All's checked in for Drummond.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
The first one falls. Schroeder hits them both. 1:31 left in the second quarter. On its way from Irving for two. Again, the Nets for two.
You know, they're looking good, really good right now because of him. He sees this game by the throat, and he's squeezing hard.
Gasol trying to free himself up.
Clearly the defense could have been better there, guys, but he also needs to convert that.
It's stolen by Schroeder. Here's Horton Tucker, defended by Durant, and it's sent back by KD. From beyond the arc, Jordan with the rebound. Jordan's got six rebounds here tonight.
Well, I admire the fact he's trying to power through this rough stretch, but on occasion, you'll have periods like this.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
And don't leave out the coaching staff here now. I mean, their game plan has been perfect.
Los Angeles with another miss. The Nets shooting a mind-boggling 79% off the floor. Count it.
Yeah, with platinum-level all-around skills, Durant can pretty much score at will.
The Lakers shooting very well, 56% from the floor here in the second quarter. The pass to Horton Tucker. No good on the triple.
And another miss. Oof. He's having a really ugly game.
Yeah, about as ugly as you can have, you're right. And they pick up two. Brown's got six in the quarter.
Wow, 10 straight points from mid-range.
You know what I've always said, partner? Good shooting covers over a multitude of ills, and we're seeing it right now.
Schroeder passes to Harrell to the left wing. Here's Horton Tucker,
and it's in. Oh, wow, he nails the buzzer, Peter.
Resourceful move there, ending the period on a high note.
Nothing like knocking down that last possession of a quarter to give you a little feel-good momentum.
A dominating first half of basketball, and so far hasn't been close. Nets out in front, opening up a huge gap. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Kentavious, you guys were getting a lot of offensive rebounds in the first half. How important was that?
Oh, man, they was important, man. We got to keep them off the glass. We can't get them second shot, and we got our offensive rebounds as well. Get us some second chance at the basket. Just keep working hard.
Well, you made it work in the first half, KCP. Thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everyone. That was a combination of everybody and everyone.
Did you catch that?
I got it.
Yeah. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal. How about that first half, fellas? What a game it's been for Kyrie Irving. He went on an historic scoring frenzy, tallying a ridiculous number of points and one assist. And from what we saw so far from the Nets, Kenny, what's your takeaway?
Oh, whenever Kyrie is engaged, he's borderline unguardable. He's feeling like he can take any shot and it will go in. And the creativity, they have no answer for him.
Shaq, what was your takeaway on the Lakers?
Well, there are a few areas they need to improve on, but perimeter defense is priority numero uno. They got to be quicker to close out on the three-point shooters. And you got to prevent the open looks. They weren't fighting through screens. They're just not doing enough, Ernie, especially outside.
That's all for now. Say goodbye to the folks.
Thanks
goodbye,
for
folks.
Joining us.
Third quarter, just about ready to begin.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. You look at Kyrie Irving in this game, he has been everywhere.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
And you know what? I'll be interested to see just how much he's got left in the tank. That first half had to take a lot out of him.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. Harris is out there with Durant. Then there's Irving. Then there's Brown. And it's Jordan in at the five down low. So that's the lineup for Brooklyn.
Boy, you've really got to put those away, especially against soft interior defense.
And here is Drummond. Schroeder outside. There's the dish to Morris. Outside for Caldwell Pope. Six on the shot clock. Puts up a three. And there's Morris. That's good on the assist by Caldwell Pope.
Three.
Caldwell Pope's got his third assist on the night.
And although it seems like KCP will never be a huge factor on offense, he can still give you valuable points and also that spacing he can provide out on the floor.
Yeah, I agree with you there. And it's a valuable tool kit that he has because he can provide some playmaking and shot making and spacing of the floor. And he's also become more efficient as an offensive player. But he does know and recognize that his strength is at the defensive end, his athleticism, mobility, and versatility. And offense is tertiary to his contributions.
Now here's Caldwell Pope following the miss by DeAndre Jordan. And Drummond throws it down.
And this is who Drummond can be, an offensive anchor who can dominate once he gets cooking.
Here's Irving. No good there. So Los Angeles will take it the other way.
And he's been a force on the glass all game long.
Yeah, I love the way he's fighting through box outs, using his elbows. I mean, he's doing whatever it takes.
KD on the wing. Ball's knocked loose. It's stolen by Morris. And now the fast break. Schroeder with the ball. Finished off the break. Schroeder's got 17 now.
Good job getting the ball and completing that play.
Boy, there's not much defense available once a steal is made. That's the best time to attack on the break.
A one-man show offensively, and that's almost always good news for his team.
And Schroeder's got the ball here for the Los Angeles Lakers. On the wing, Morris. No good on the three.
A slight rebound advantage for them. One more column in their favor. And it's all adding up.
Well, you take a look at all of the stats, the team stats, that is, and that's one of the many areas that they've had the advantage. And as a result, they've got a big lead.
And it's still a rare sight to see rebound numbers like the ones he's had tonight.
Boy, he has put in some major work. He's earning his pay, for sure.
And just scrapes and claws for that offensive rebound and doesn't take any chances there with the putback.
And G.A., strong work all around. And the rebound and the stuff both. Wow.
Yep, he stayed with it all the way and got his reward at the end.
aggressive defense, the battle with Drummond inside is a collision waiting to happen.
From 11 feet away, another one falls for Brooklyn.
You know, that's exactly how they wanted to run that possession, guys. Beautiful.
Lakers have gone just a bit under 50% from the field since halftime. 5 out of 11. Passes it to Caldwell Pope. To the middle. And Morris throws it down.
And really just led him to his sweet spot for that finish.
For Brooklyn, they've gone 4 of 9 from the floor so far in the third. Irving. And another one falls.
My goodness. 50 for the game.
Yep, he is putting on a show. Kuzma outside. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
That's his first personal foul.
When Kuzma first entered the league, the Lakers were a rebuilding team. Now, Greg, he's one of the more experienced pieces on this team.
And Kuzma's made the most of it, switching to a learning role, tries to absorb as much as he can from the vets, and he does everything he can to pick their brain and improve on those little things in terms of championship caliber basketball.
And that one misses.
Well, you look at Kuzma, the 27th overall pick in the NBA draft, guys, a multi-talented, confident forward with impressive skill and potential.
Looking at who's out there now for the Nets, Griffin's checked in for Jordan. Green comes in for Kevin Durant. And it's Luwawu Cabarro in for Bruce Brown. He hits the second from the line. They're making this a runaway.
And the only question for me right now is just how big the lead will eventually become.
Lakers have gotten 6 of their 12 shots to drop for him here in the second half so far. Pass to Caldwell Pope. And a miss there on the triple. And for Brooklyn, their shooting has been sensational. 75% for the game. And Green gets it to go. Here's Caruso, currently averaging almost 6 points a game. Morris outside. Drummond trying to get himself free. Morris, no good. Nets shooting it well here in the third, about 50%. A nice shot by Griffin.
Yeah, he's become very reliable with that mid-range jump shot. The defense can't let him get comfortable from there.
L.A. has gone 1 of 4 in three-point shots here in the third. Down low, here's Drummond, and Drummond throws it down.
I tell you what a good thing that he showed up today, because without him, this thing would already be over.
Here's Green. Another one falls for Brooklyn.
And even with the big lead, he remains focused on the task at hand.
Yeah, and you know, that is some shaky and shoddy defensive work. They got to tighten it up.
And Morris throws it down.
Boy, you've got to appreciate the passing there. Results in a great look.
Here's Green. Again, the Nets for two.
And a smooth jump shot from the veteran Green there. These are looks he nails consistently.
To the paint, here's Morris. That's in for his 8th bucket tonight. A hot 8 for 11 shooting so far.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Pulls up on the elbow. And that one hits back iron. The Lakers shooting 56% in this game, really stringing quality possessions together offensively.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
And here is Los Angeles now, after the basket by Brooklyn. And Caldwell Pope gets the basket. Caldwell Pope's got 5 points so far.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's 4 straight field goals now they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
Impressive, really, from that short 17 area. They are not missing many.
You're exactly right. I mean, they've banged home 8 of their last 10 points on mid-range jumpers.
And good that time. 8 points for him.
You know, body him up all you want. It doesn't bother Kyle Kuzma. He's got great competitive spirit and skill.
and it's Green missing. And Los Angeles guys shooting an outstanding 55% from the field since the half. You know, their execution has been on point. Caruso kicks to Morris from past the arc. The rebound by Luwawu.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Morris has got 7 rebounds in the game. Here's Kuzma. And the three off target.
And not a night he's going to want to remember. Just not really able to score the basketball.
Offensive rebound. Green. It's good. Now he's shooting 6 for 7.
Just creating havoc for the opponents the last few games.
Well, he's done it again right there on the offensive glass. I mean, it's a great stretch that he's having here. And, boy, I really admire his energy.
And the shot goes down.
The defense not putting up any fight on the inside. They've allowed 10 straight points in the paint.
That's not the kind of streak you want to be part of defensively. Tighten it up, fellas. You have to love the unselfishness on display there. Excellent passing.
Here's Caruso. Fires for three. Drills the three-pointer. Kuzma's got 8 points here in this quarter.
A good look there, and he didn't waste it. His second three of the game.
Here's Griffin. Lays it up and in on the nice reverse.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
And it's been a well-rounded performance. I mean, strong rebound.
What a jam!
Are you kidding me?
Woo! Nasty. Wow. We are going to remember that one for a while.
I know I will, Greg. That was special. That was really special.
A circus dunk for you right there, guys.
Here's Caruso. He's covered by Irving, and it's Drummond with the jam.
And although an undersized center, more than making up for it with some serious hops.
Here's Luwawu, not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down. Luwawu's got his second basket. And it's Kuzma with the ball for the Lakers. Lobbed up there for Drummond, and it's Drummond with the jam.
And I like the timing that Drummond has on these alley-oops. That's not as easy as he makes it look. He knows precisely when to leave the ground to receive the pass and finish it off.
Now a timeout call by Brooklyn.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and the coach sees something he doesn't like here.
And you know what? We'll see what changes he makes coming out of this timeout.
The Lakers making a change here. Playoff seeding so important here. Let's have a look out west. You take a look at Los Angeles. They're having a solid season. Fifth in the conference and looking to move up.
And when I look at the Lakers, this hasn't been the breakout season that many were predicting, but they're still very much in the hunt for a high postseason seed, and that will keep them focused here during the season's final stages.
And they need to stay focused. I mean, they have to ensure they hang on to a high seed. It's imperative for them.
Morris passes to Caruso. They grab their own miss. Another shot, and it's sent back by Aldridge.
You know, over time, Aldridge has really developed into a pretty good shot blocker.
Shot from the wing. Claxton, no good. Lakers shooting has been just great so far, up at 56%. Matthews, no good. And for Brooklyn, their shooting has been just uncontainable, 72%. Claxton, the pass to Aldridge. Over Harrell. Pass to Claxton. Inside and stolen by Harrell. And here comes the break. Here's Horton Tucker. cranes the jumper to finish the break.
Yes, sir.
Horton Tucker's got 8 points.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
You know, the defense has really been kept off balance because of the outstanding passes. 4 straight field goals have been made off an assist.
It's good.
Well, his IQ is one of the best in the league. Irvin has a great feel for when his teammates are open.
And Los Angeles guys shooting it quite well in this third quarter, 53%, and the offense is rolling. Here's Horton Tucker. A three-pointer off the mark. This could get even more out of hand if they continue to put up points.
Wow, Kevin, what a performance we are seeing.
They get the rebound. Now the pass to Harris. He clangs that one off the back iron, and down it falls. Harris has got 4 points this quarter. Passes it to Caruso. To the inside, Horton Tucker takes the assist and lays it in. Picked out the pass nicely.
And that's almost automatic anytime he can get the ball in that position.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. 2 points, that one goes. 7 points in the game.
And the jump shot has been a dimension of this game where they've had a clear advantage.
They keep pulling up and watching them go down. It's a really nice thing to see.
Here's Chioza. 1 second left. And the last shot before the buzzer is off. And so it's Brooklyn holding an unbelievable lead as the quarter wraps up. From the field, they have been outstanding, amazing shooting. That's what has them headed to a blowout. And we've got more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way after this break. And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. The Nets shooting 71% all in all in this one. They've been brilliant offensively. And on the court for the Lakers to start the fourth. We've got Matthews. Marc Gasol is out there with Harrell. Then it's McLemore. And it's Horton Tucker in at the three spot. Horton Tucker, the pass to Harrell. Oh, and he plucks it off the glass. Wow.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Chioza's shot is good. And now we'll get a perspective here on the hustle game, how it's been going for the Nets.
You know, block shots, guys, a clear indicator on the stat sheet of their excellent defense. I mean, leaving them no room to get off any shots.
Yeah, but also, they haven't missed a beat in terms of their fast break game. That's been equally as effective all night long.
And a chance there to look back at the stunning mobile one block a moment ago.
And read the play perfectly, gets himself in the air at the right moment. Terrific denial.
And the Lakers making a change here. McKinney's checked in. Feeds to Gasol, and Gasol slams it in.
Matthews has a nice feel, guys, for when a teammate has a clean look, gets him the ball.
Here's Johnson. Rebound the Lakers.
I wouldn't say that's exactly his spot now. I mean, and you can see why.
Scooped up. A nice shot by Gasol.
Yeah, just showing off that strength. In that upper body, Gasol is able to overpower the defender inside.
Goes back up. Claxton with the bucket.
How frustrating for the defense. You get the stop, but then fail to block out.
Well, you know, that's the way it's going to be for them today, fellas. Can't sustain any momentum.
Pass to Matthews from downtown. They get it back. Tries yet again. Shot's good by McKinney. McKinney's got his first bucket in this one.
And they've shown a little extra hustle on the offensive glass here in the second half. Second chance points are starting to add up for them, and they can use every one of them.
And we're around 2 minutes into the fourth quarter here. Inside, here's McLemore, uses the glass to finish the layup.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
Durant just inside the line. Another one falls for Brooklyn.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
Yeah, I love the fact he doesn't play the score. He just keeps coming, attack mode. He doesn't know how to step off the gas pedal.
+8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Yeah, double-digit advantage on the scoreboard. They've taken the initiative. They've played, I think, with more purpose so far.
Jordan, he's checked in for Nicholas Claxton. Dennis Schroeder's checked in for the Lakers. Los Angeles has gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Down low, Gasol. And Gasol with the dunk.
Yeah, and it doesn't take much elevation for Gasol to throw one down, of course, unless somebody's standing right in his way. That dunk is going to be easy money for him.
Schroeder outside, fires from deep. It's hauled in by LaMarcus Aldridge. Aldridge has got his fourth rebound in this one. The shot. Gasol trying to free himself up. That one a tad offline to the right, but drops in for him.
You know, whether he's posting up, spotting up, or working the pick and roll, Aldridge has a versatile game.
McLemore, no good. And here's Chioza. He'll bring it up for Brooklyn. They've got the Timberwolves ahead of them next in Minneapolis. That'll be the first half of a two-game trip. Here's Durant. Can't hit that one. Good work defensively by Gasol. And Los Angeles guys shooting in the fourth quarter has looked shabby, 38%. And the Lakers with another miss. For Brooklyn, they've gone 6 of 11 since the start of the fourth quarter. Jordan with it. Matthews covering. Durant kicks to Jordan. Shoots over Matthews, and that one goes long.
Yeah, you know, he hasn't contributed well scoring the ball, but obviously his teammates have.
Schroeder against Aldridge. And that one's good. Schroeder. Schroeder's got 19 points.
Again and again, they're dissecting the defense and creating those high-percentage looks from inside.
And even under pressure in close, I think they've still done a good job maintaining concentration and converting the opportunities.
And I'm not really sure that's the time for the fadeaway, but he sure can make it count.
Outside Gasol. That's tipped. Outside Matthews. The tray. Drops in the tray.
Man, he's got great range and rhythm as a dangerous shooter, especially from deep where he shoots it with ease.
Now a timeout call by Brooklyn. A lot of talk about receding in the playoffs when you got down to the final four teams. If it ensures the two best teams make the finals, it would seem to me, Greg, to be worth it. What about you?
You know, it could be. I think about the worldwide attention on that championship round, but you got to get the Eastern Conference teams to sign off on that. And, you know, we've seen it happen in the past where the power shifts from one conference to the other. But ultimately, nothing better than seeing the two best teams play for it all.
So for the Nets, Blake Griffin comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. And it's Luwawu Cabarro in for Durant. And the Lakers also making a change. Antetokounmpo's checked in. Here's Chioza. He's guarded by Schroeder. The Lakers have gone 7-16 from the field here in the fourth. That's about 43%. And the Lakers tack on two more.
And he can take over in a nanosecond. I mean, once he catches fire, it's difficult to squelch it.
Here's Chiosa. He's guarded by Schroeder, and he comes up with the deuce.
Man, he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
McKinney passes to Schroeder. And there's the defensive three-second call. And the league taking steps to discourage teams, Greg, from tossing away seasons in search of high draft picks. Has enough been done, you think, in that regard?
We'll see. I tell you, the idea of a play-in
that's
tournament
a tough one, isn't it?
Few playoff spots, I think that's a good idea, actually. It might keep more teams in the hunt down the stretch. And I think the onus also, if the fans put enough pressure on their teams to try to develop what they have and not always put it on the future, I think that's going to help. But I think you're going to always have a little bit of that moving forward.
And here is Los Angeles now. Here's McKinney. Shot clock at 5. Lakers working the ball around now. Beyond the arc. And it's Schroeder missing.
Timeout. Rare you'll see him miss such an open look.
Now a timeout call by Brooklyn.
And team strategies closely guarded. One aspect of the game the fans aren't always privy to.
Yeah, typically there's some type of adjustment made out of a timeout. It might be major or it could be just a slight tweak.
The Nets have gone 8 of 16 from the field in the fourth, exactly 50%. Pulls up, high post, and it falls over the rim and in. Chiosa's got 8 points in the quarter.
Nice piece of work there. Get yourself a little space and pull the trigger.
Here's Schroeder. And again, no good by the Lakers.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Guys, that's putting it mildly. I mean, they've been absolutely dominant.
Here's Jordan. Count it from 12.
He didn't have a single point in the first half. Bagel, 0 points, nada. But he's starting to get into the groove here in the second.
Now here's Schroeder. D right on him.
And, you know, passes like that go a long way. Terrific teamwork.
And so it's Johnson who brings the ball up for the Brooklyn Nets. Over McLemore. Tries again. The rebound by Gasol. Gasol's got 4 rebounds now tonight.
And thus far, they've managed to overcome an off game from him offensively.
To the middle. And finished off by Gasol.
And he just elevates and powers in the one-hander.
Mm-hmm. Textbook.
I'm glad he didn't go overboard and try to do too much there.
The shot's good from Jordan.
Encouraging signs for him after starting the game poorly. He's picked it up here in the second half.
Now here's Schroeder to the paint. Then Gasol with the dunk.
And excellent production tonight from Gasol. His numbers being called, and he is not disappointing.
And Luau gets it to go.
The ball distribution was there. I mean, outstanding work all the way around.
And for the Lakers, they're shooting it really well. 54% from the floor. Plenty of daylight on that shot.
The D just sagged off just enough and no hesitation on his part.
Here's Griffin. Rebound the Lakers. McKinney's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. Greg, after we saw top prospects like LaMelo Ball and R.J. Hampton playing a year in Australia, the NBA G League sweetened the deal to attract those blue chippers to this G League, which I think is a very interesting topic and a very interesting way to go.
It is. You know, I think the salaries now could exceed $500,000, not to mention the endorsement deals. And they're on a single team that's built around their needs. Certainly an enticing option for those who want to skip the college route.
Does this affect colleges, in your opinion, in their recruiting?
Not at all. You're going to love your school no matter who plays for them, especially if you're winning.
You make your teammates better by giving them good passes. That one was perfect.
Here's Chiosa. Here's Jordan. That's all good, and that's his fifth basket of the game. He's shooting 5 for 11 now.
And you can just see he's a different player since coming back from halftime.
And that one's good. Schroeder.
The defense just too soft on that possession. You have to be closer and contest at the rim.
Knocked loose. And that one is good.
You know, he was a non-factor in that first half, but now he's making up for lost time.
And Los Angeles guys shooting and hitting almost everything here in the fourth, up around 58% from the field. Here's McKinney. They get it again. He feeds it to Gasol and finished off by Gasol.
And that's why you don't let him get positioned deep in the post.
Exactly. I mean, once he's got the ball in that area, the battle's already lost.
There's 1:54 left in the fourth quarter.
And he just punishes the D for falling asleep at the wheel.
Yeah, a little disorganized that time. And the result, 2 points in the loudest way possible.
Guys, there has to be better rim protection than that, though. Not very good.
That's good from Schroeder on the assist from McLemore. McLemore's got 4 assists now tonight. And for Brooklyn, they're shooting fairly well in the fourth, around 48%. And again, no good by Brooklyn. Lakers shooting has been beyond great up until now. How about 57% from the field overall? And throw the ball out of bounds. Jordan touched it last. Alex Caruso, he's checked in for Dennis Schroeder. Puts it up off the inbound. The rebound by Johnson. Nets shooting an impressive 65%, having their way with this defense.
And as we head to the final buzzer here, a crushing blowout. Big time dominance. And this will go in the record books as a gaudy win for the Nets.
You don't see this kind of a blowout often. But tonight, this is a quality win across the board to deliver out this kind of punishment.
They definitely never changed the approach. They just kept after it and showed they were clearly the better team in just about every single category.
And so checking out the record for these guys, tonight will mark win number 37 for them on the year.
Really, they had their number this season. 2 wins, a home win, and an away win.
Yeah, you know, I thought the result might be a little different this time around, but clearly I was mistaken. Now they'll have to wait till next year for a shot at revenge.
And we watched one guy all night long, guys, and looking at the stats just confirms what a dominant game he had. What a night tonight it was for Kyrie Irving.
There wasn't much they could do to slow him down as he was converting every good chance he got.
Now, a moment to present the New Balance Player of the Game, Dennis Schroeder.
And guys, no doubt who our pick was going to be. He's made everyone else on the court look like they're playing at half speed.
it's been total domination, and you can't help but just sit back and admire that performance.
DeAndre Jordan's checked in for the Nets. 58 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one.
And you can sense that these fans, these players, they are ready to celebrate.
And I think they can start that celebration right now. I mean, what a terrific team victory.
Nailed from three-point land.
Look, it's always great to get into a rhythm, but do it when it matters.
Now they're playing with urgency, huh? They could have done it much earlier before the game was out of reach.
And out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession. Wesley Matthews checked in for Los Angeles. 41 seconds left in the fourth. And Caruso's got the ball here for Los Angeles. Here's McKinney. Fires the three. And again, Los Angeles with the triple.
And guys, there are some you can give that shot to. But let's be clear, he's not one of them. Terrible job there by the D.
And Brooklyn turns it over again.
Lakers ball.
Seconds left in the fourth quarter. The feed to Antetokounmpo. And Antetokounmpo slams it in.
What a fantastic finish there on the break.
A textbook kickback to set up the easy finish.
Here's Chiosa. And he gets the whistle for the three-second call. Here's McKinney. And so it's Brooklyn easily grabbing this one. And the outcome of this one was never in doubt.
And boy, they really put in a supreme effort. It just felt like once they had that lead and it was comfortable, they were not going to relinquish it.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. DeAndre, what do you think this team's identity is this season?
We just have so many guys that can score. It's going to be somebody's night every night, like I keep saying. But we're also, our half-court offense is getting a lot better.
The ball is moving around, DeAndre. Thanks for your time. Kevin?
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our terrific 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. So long and good night, everyone.